My original idea was to make a talk about the negative effects of stereotyping on the adolescent mind. I had gathered a lot of content. Everything was going great when suddenly it struck me. With people shattering glass ceilings, breaking all kinds of stereotypes around the world, if that is still not enough to convince some to stop stereotyping, then let's face it. Yet another speech on this topic isn't really going to do much good. And it was precisely at that moment that another realization dawned upon me. No matter how much we try to keep an open mind, to not be confined to constrictive thinking, somewhere, somehow, we are unconsciously submitting to these labels because it's one such thing that is deeply embedded in our mindset. A society without stereotypes is still light years away. False beliefs about our abilities easily turn into a voice of self-doubt that can be hard to ignore. What with people telling us who we are, who we are supposed to be, what we can do, what we can't, all based on generalization. If I can't change the way people think, is there no way to deal with these toxic stereotypes? Girls are assumed to be incompetent sportsmen. Sensitive boys are considered weak. Intellectual people are termed to be socially awkward. Is there no way to deal with these toxic labels? The answer, yes, there is. We may not be able to change the way others think, but we can definitely control the way we deal with the situation. And that is why today, I have decided to give my talk on multiple ways we as individuals can deal with stereotypes. I have compiled a list of methods and strategies that can help us to cope with the negative effects of stereotypes, or as scientists have now decided to call it, the stereotype threat. Method number one, talk it out. My advice to the millions of people around the world who are victims of labeling, don't keep it bottled up. It is overwhelming and can have a detrimental effect. Talk to someone you trust and who you know cares for you. Maybe your parents, a teacher or a mentor, a sibling, a close friend, anyone. Because sometimes all you need is the reassurance that there's nothing wrong with being you. You're wonderful just the way you are. I can vouch for this method personally, and let me tell you, it works wonders. I've never been one to care much about what others think of me, but a new city, a new school, sometimes it's hard. And all of a sudden, there was a part of me which wanted desperately to be popular, to be cool, to be liked by everyone. And I thought to myself, the only way that was going to happen was if I changed myself according to the predefined molds of who is cool and who is not. In trying to change myself according to these stereotypes, I lost a big chunk of me, my identity. I was sensible enough to understand what I was doing was wrong. I didn't need to change myself. Yet, I was doing it because these labels are something extremely hard to fight. My parents helped me a lot during that time, and I wouldn't have managed to rediscover myself if not for their support. Method number two, relevant role models are important. When Barack Obama was elected as the 44th president of the United States of America, his stereotype-defying success had a positive effect on African Americans, according to the Marx, Ho, and Friedman study. This is termed as the Obama effect. Therefore, such role models can provide motivation to others to tread the challenging paths. Also, many of us belong to a few different groups. Sometimes it's worth shifting the focus to the one which gives us strength. For example, Asian women underperformed on a math test when reminded of their gender identity, but not when their Asian identity was made salient. This is because Asian individuals are stereotypically seen as being good in math. This was the stereotype susceptibility, identity salience, and shifts in quantitative performance study. Gaining confidence by practicing the otherwise threatening task could also be beneficial. One way to do this could be by reframing the task as a challenge. A personal experience. When some girls around me gave up on mathematics, simply stopped trying because of the perception that math is too difficult for girls, I took it up as a challenge. I worked hard and I got better and better. and I proved not only to myself but to others as well that your aptitude or your interests don't depend on your gender. Last but not the least, believing in yourself. To be able to tell yourself that these stereotypes don't matter. I won't sugarcoat my words by saying that it's going to be easy, because frankly, it won't. But one day, all of us can reach there. The moment we learn to tell ourselves that our individuality is what makes us unique. The moment we learn to look at ourselves through our own eyes instead of someone else's. That is when there is a dynamic shift in our approach to stereotypes. That is when stereotypes stop affecting us. Thank you.